Evening, ladies and gentlemen, guests of honor, all dignitaries, all Uganda AIDS Commission and all the partners, everybody from our friends, family, thank you for coming today. I'm going to start off by reading a letter that my father wrote to his older brother before he came out to disclose his predicament. He says, "Dear brother, it's with utmost regret that I inform you the sickness which has been bothering me has been diagnosed as AIDS. You are no doubt shocked, but imagine how shocked I was when I was told by my doctors. The purpose for this letter is to tell you in my own words, because I know rumors have already reached Kampala. Even here among the Ugandan community, I am big news, especially when I'm away from the public, even for a few days. I was invited for last year's Christmas festivities, which I did not attend because I was in hospital, but this is when the rumors started, and everybody confirmed that there was indeed something wrong because I did not show up. Well, I won't go into more about that. I'm planning to come to Uganda in the near future with the sole purpose of making a press conference. I want to inform the public that I have this dreaded disease. As a popular musician and a citizen of Uganda, it is my duty to give my fellow Ugandans a clear picture of what has happened to me. Because of my reputation and good standard as a musician, I must take part in informing the people. This might perhaps save some lives. If I had known about AIDS, what I know today, I would perhaps be telling a different story. What I want now is to give AIDS a face, as we call it here in the West, by publicly exposing and admitting before the masses that I have AIDS. Perhaps we can give confidence and hope to other unknown AIDS patients. Many of them are often discarded and rejected by their relatives as soon as the disease is diagnosed. Please, may I request that you, for the time being, keep this to yourself and Muzei, he meant his mother, until I tell you exactly what I'm planning to do. For the short time that I have left in this world, I plan to go on working, and all we had planned must go on as scheduled. I must record for those Christmas concerts, which will undoubtedly be my last appearances on stage in Uganda. I intend to show by doing this that instead of desperation, one can still be useful to society even if partially disabled. I regret any inconvenience and embarrassment this might cause to you, our family, and friends. But there it is, now you know. Your loving brother, Philly." This was written by my father a month before he came in 1988. And from this letter, it's very befitting this today's theme, sustainability for Uganda's HIV/AIDS response post-2020. But as we can see, on December 15th, it will be 30 years since he passed away. But as I read this letter, I felt that it was relevant because it speaks to us today and especially to our theme. Here is a man who 30 years ago was in a situation where there was no information. Medicines were not readily available, and everything was still in discovery mode. But he was hit with a disease that he did not know anything about, had never heard of, and that he did what he did is very inspiring to me and to many, many other young people, some of whom have approached and told me about how they've benefited from his legacy. So I'm glad that this topic has come up, because from his letter, there are three things that I take from it that we still need to put into account as we fight for sustainability post-2020. Number one is, first of all, in the letter, he's talking to not only his brother, but he's talking to you and everybody, every one of us, because we all need to join in this fight and do something personally. It's not a fight that we should leave to donors, government. It is us who have to start within ourselves, our homes, our communities, and then it spreads wider. But he inspires me, and he talked about stigma. It's still a very big issue today because it affects everybody in all different kinds of ways, work, communities, schools. We know that there's a lot of young people who were born with the virus. If this is 30 years ago, many of them are in their 30s and younger. So they need to be inspired, and they need to be included in whatever we try to do post-2020, because they have voices that we cannot... they have the voices that we need to hear from. So the stigma is still a big issue. And then resilience. For example, how does one bounce back after a diagnosis or loss of a family member who is a breadwinner? How do people bounce back in these situations? All these things need to be tackled. Because today we know there's a lot of support, and there are many tools that are available to us and the younger generation. So we need to make sure that everybody is able to access these tools in various parts of Uganda. And then social capital. The social capital that he built through his one-man campaign in the midst of rejection, he used the music, which was his solace and his champion, sort of something that pushed him to fight on whenever he was thinking of giving up. But resilience and determination, we need to dig into those deeply as people. Using our, we're all gifted in some kind of way, and I think we can all contribute using this social capital in some way. As somebody mentioned here, musicians should be used because they reach a wider audience, even where government cannot reach, music and musicians can get to. So I express my gratitude to Uganda Aids Commission, Director General, and all your partners that have kept the legacy alive. We really appreciate you, and I'm sure my father really appreciates. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen.
Lutaaya. And before I give you this message, this song, let me pass a simple message to fellow people living with HIV. Stop crying. Stop misbehaving. Stop. Imagine Philly Lutaaya went through a lot without medications. And here you are. You have the medications, and yet you don't want to take them. Those people, the Philly Lutaayas, suffered a lot. They didn't have any intervention to control their viral load. But for us, we have the interventions to control our viral loads, but you are not taking the medications, and these medications are very expensive. Can you imagine? Okay. A simple song for Philly. It goes like this. Okay, you just say, Philly, are we ready? Endure the stigma and pain. Educated me and you. Was born in Africa. Philly Lutaaya is my hero. How many people believe that Philly Lutaaya is their hero? Hey, you are many. Can you stand up, please, and sing for Philly? Can you sing for Philip, please? Just endure the stigma and pain. Educated me and you. Was born in Africa. Philly Lutaaya is my hero. Yakola nyo babu we. Atachimanyi weba se. Yabunyisa nyenjiri. Philly Lutaaya is my hero. DJ, give me the song. Can I request the director?